kitchen, I told you earlier, when we were dealing with the probation violation, I asked you about Charles Kitchen, who was here. And I told you that I tried him twice in 1989 in this very room for exactly the same thing. It was a gang shooting in East Lake. It's to the point now that I say it almost every day of my life. And I'm gonna keep saying it until somebody finally listens. But there are three ways out of that life. You either walk away and you say, I'm done, and I'm not gonna be a statistic. Or you get carried away. You either get carried away by the police, or you get carried away by the car. Those are the only options. And in this case, it's particularly egregious because, just like your cousin's case, an innocent guy got shot. Mr. Culver didn't have anything to do with it. He didn't have anything to do with y'all. He was shot to a wrong guy. Not only did you shoot the wrong guy, you were after the wrong guy to start with. Like I said, until somebody finally starts listening, I'm going to keep saying it. I understand, I read this letter from Chicago, and that's an all too familiar story. You can't do much about the way you were raised, but you can absolutely do something about the way that you lived. You chose this life, then you could have made another choice.